Extreme finitism presents... Astounding! 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 and so on does not equal minus 1/12. This is a response video to the Numberphile video called Astounding, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 and so on equals minus 1/12, in which it claims if you add up all the natural numbers all the way up to infinity, the answer is minus 1/12. In this video, we will reveal the truth about minus 1/12. First off, when we manipulate a series that does not end, the rigorous approach is to work with respect to the nth term. Here we have the series S1, and the S stands for series, not sum. It would be misleading to call it a sum because the series has no end point and so cannot have a sum. We have an unspecified number of terms up to the nth term, and the series continues endlessly after the nth term. Now we can add another S1 and shift some terms, and notice how we line up the endless parts after the nth term. Here we simply add these two together, then we divide through by 2 to get this new expression for series S1. If you use a less rigorous method, you might end up losing the end part of this result and be left with S1 equals 1/2, but if you end up with an endless series being equal to a fixed value, then you've made a mistake. Now if we drop the endless part, we find we found an expression for the sum to the nth term. We have derived the partial sum expression. The fixed part of this expression would be called the limit if we had a converging series. But with a diverging series like this one, the fixed part is what remains after this diverging part is removed. And it could be argued that this is what the informal approach tries to achieve. And so what happens if we use our rigorous approach to do all the manipulations that they used in the Astounding Results video to get the minus 1/12 result? If we include an expression for the nth term in each series, and then we do the same manipulations done in the Numberphile video but with rigour, then we get the series S equals minus 1/12 plus 1/12 plus n times n plus 1 over 2 plus endless terms after the nth term. The informal method dropped these trailing terms, leaving S equals minus 1/12 as the result. But here, the first two terms cancel out, leaving an expression for the partial sum plus endless terms after the nth term. But what about other methods that get this minus 1/12 result? Well, these methods are all trying to assign a value to a diverging series by removing the diverging parts. Now we can see from the partial sum that removing the diverging part leaves 0, not minus 1/12. So there is still the question of how these methods can examine the sum of positive whole numbers and end up with a non-positive, non-whole number result. Well, subtraction operations will bring negative numbers into play, and division operations will take us out of the realm of whole numbers. Now let's see what this means in terms of a graph. Here is a graph of our partial sum function. The graph is plotted for decimals, not whole numbers, and includes negative numbers. Removing the diverging parts in this case means removing the shaded in parts. Our mysterious value of minus 1/12 is the limit of the area that remains beneath the x-axis. Note that if we take a function that applies to positive whole numbers and we examine it with respect to decimal and negative numbers, we will inevitably introduce a skew of 1 to the left or right of the y-axis, and we often get symmetry around x equals 1/2 or minus 1/2. And our mysterious value of minus 1/12 is simply a property of the way this graph is skewed towards the negative numbers. So let's take negatives into consideration. If we use our partial sum expression to calculate the sum up to the fourth term, then we get the correct result of 10. The problem is, we have not defined what should happen if we use negative values for n. The obvious choice is to aim for symmetry. With symmetry, if we plugged minus 4 into our function, we should get a result of minus 10. But as it stands, if we plug minus 4 into our function, we get plus 6. This is due to the skew we mentioned earlier. To adjust our function for negative values, we first apply the modulus operator, like so. Then we multiply by n over the modulus of n, and we get a function that works in the same way for both negative and positive numbers. If we plot decimal values for this corrected function, we now see symmetry about the axes. And removing the diverging parts will no longer leave anything resembling minus 1/12. And what about the zeta function at minus 1? Well, if we follow the same logic to adjust for negative numbers as we did earlier, we get symmetry about the axes. And the function would not be defined at minus 1. So how astounding is all of this? Well, 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on does not equal minus 1/12. And minus 1/12 is not some mysterious value that infinity has revealed to us. It is merely a property of the skew we get when we neglect to adjust for negative values. So maybe this is not such an astounding result after all. This video was brought to you by ExtremeFinitism.com in association with Reveal Computer Software.